So glad that the mundane things of life didn't hold him home tonight. And also the stupidity of Hollywood. That they left their homes and came to the house of God. And David said he was rejoicing and happy when it was time to go to the house of God. And so we're all happy tonight. We're all rejoicing tonight. We're all glad to be here tonight. Well, hallelujah! Verse 1 says, and then the day of Pentecost was fully come. They were all in one place and one accord. Here we are, Lord. Let it go. Let it go, Lord. We're here, 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 Lord. Glory to God. Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And all the people said,
amen. The glory train is here. Chop, chop. Let's get into it, church. Bible angel number 808. And the pronunciation for this word is askemosune. 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 Bible Angel Numbers 808. Let's get into it. What's poppin'? Today's focus of studies is going to be in Romans, Revelations, and then we're going to extend it down to Exodus and Deuteronomy. Okay? So make sure you have your Bibles out, church. And let's get started. Romans 1, and I'm going to start at verse 20. For the invisible things in him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their own imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools and changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image made like to corruptible man, into birds and four-footed beasts and creeping things. Wherefore God also gave them up to uncleanness through the lusts of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of God into a lie and worshipped and served the creature more than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause God gave them up unto vile affections, for even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error which was meet. Now let's skip forward to Exodus, and we're going to go to chapter 20, and we're going to begin. I want to read verse 20 through 26, okay, and then I'm just going to jump to some of the Ten Commandments. So let's take it from the top. Verse 20. And Moses said unto the people, fear not, for God is come to prove you, and that his fear may be before your faces that ye sin not. And the people stood afar off, and Moses drew near unto the thick darkness where God was. And the Lord said unto Moses, thus thou shalt say unto the children of Israel, ye have seen that I have talked with you from heaven. Ye shall not make with me gods of silver, neither shall ye make unto you gods of gold. An altar of earth thou shalt make unto me, and shall sacrifice thereon thy burnt offerings, and thy peace offerings, thy sheep, and thine oxen. In all places where I record my name, I will come unto thee, and I will bless thee. And if thou wilt make me an altar of stone, thou shalt not build it of hewn stone. For if thou lift up thy tool upon it, thou hast polluted it. Neither shall thou go up by steps unto mine altar.
You, Israel, you have sinned a great sin in the sight of God. You are not worthy to receive these Ten Commandments.
We gathered against you, Moses. You take too much upon yourself. We will not live by your commandments. We're free.
Hey, there is no freedom without the law.
Whose law, Moses? Yours? Did you carve those tablets to become a prince over us?
Who is on the Lord's side? Let him come to me. Idolaters, for this you shall drink bitter waters. God has set before you this day his laws of life and good and death and evil. Those who will not live by the law shall die.
Predicting pandemics, and these children of the devil predicting dark winters. Predicting pandemics, and these children of the devil predicting dark winters. It's easy to predict something they already had a plan to do, and then turn around and look like they're predicting things, like Bill Gates predicting pandemics, and these children of the devil predicting dark winters. It's easy to predict something they already had a plan to do, and then turn around and look like there's some great person that actually warned us of something coming, when they are the ones that are causing the chaos. But just remember something, when they were predicting a dark winter, while planning to do it all the while, they ain't the one who decides if we have a dark winter. God does.
Don't you realize, saints, it's everywhere, because it's Satan, is God of the air. This is his kingdom for a time, but our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, he is coming back. He is coming back, church. Look around you. Look at all the sin, all the evil, all the warfare. It's all spiritual, church. Can't you see? Deuteronomy 23:14, for the Lord your God moves about in your camp to protect you and to deliver your enemies to you. Your camp must be holy so that he will not see among you anything indecent and turn away from you.
Thank you.
church? Are you naked and afraid? Are you full of shame? Do you have unseemly deeds? Are you indecent by implication? I just want to let you know that there has been a plan in place since the beginning of the foundation of the earth. Okay, our Lord and our Savior had a plan for our life. And then we have the adversary who also has a wicked plan for our life. John 10:10. For the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy, but the Lord has come to give us life and give it to us abundantly. Grab on to life abundantly, to the Lord Jesus Christ. Lay your life down and take up the cross. Jeremiah 33:3. Call to me and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. New world order is here, saints. We must fight the good fight. These devils want blood, and they're thirsty. They literally want our blood. Fight the good fight.